Remember, my dear Islamic brothers, it is a fact that a number of Muslims will be punished in the fire due to their sins. So why does each and every Muslim not fear that he might be amongst them? The pain felt due to a bullet wound is nothing compared to the punishment of hell. A hadith of Muslim Sharif states that the mildest punishment in hell is that a man will have to wear shoes of fire, which will make his brain boil like water does in a kettle. But the man subjected to this punishment will think that this is the worst punishment. A hadith in Bukhari Sharif states that he will be asked on the day of judgment by Allah Azza wa Jal, if you own the entire universe, would you give it all as fidya to stop this punishment? He will scream out, yes, Ya Allah Azza wa Jal. In other words, yes, I'll give everything. Please just take these shoes off my feet. Please just get rid of this punishment. My dear Islamic brothers, think to yourself again and again. What if someone is punished with this lightest punishment for committing a major sin, a minor sin? What will he do? What if one of us swears, although this is a major sin, but what if he has to suffer only the lightest punishment? What will he do? What if he hurts the feelings of his parents? This is a major sin. But what if he has to suffer the lightest punishment? Is it bearable? Think about the sins you commit on a daily basis. What if because of lying, backbiting, telling tales, earning unlawfully, intoxicating oneself, watching films and dramas, listening to music, or even news from a female newscaster on TV, one has to suffer the lightest punishment? What will he do? How unfortunate is that female newscaster who, in order to earn a mere amount of money, reads out news on TV? Would that she would realize that thousands of men are committing sin by watching her, filling their eyes with haram, which may lead to hell, and she is also committing a great sin herself. Anyhow, my dear Islam brothers, anyone who says he only has a TV so that he can watch the news must listen carefully. It is haram for a man to glance at a woman and for a woman to cast a lustful glance at a man, and this will lead to hell. What if one has to suffer the lightest punishment and wear shoes of fire for just watching the news on the TV? My dear Islamic brothers, although there will be much more severe modes of punishment in hell, at least become afraid of the lightest punishment. If you want to learn about these punishments, I suggest you read the written version of one of the speeches of Amir Ahl Sunnat, which is called Pur Israr Khazana, the secret treasure, or listen to the audio version. Hopefully, you will find yourself trembling with the fear of Allah Azza wa Jal after reading it. Ask yourself, what if I just have to suffer the mildest punishment for missing Salah with the Jamaat? What will I do if I have to wear shoes of fire for not avoiding looking at Ghair Mahram, or being informal with my sister-in-law, or looking at her deliberately, or not avoiding contact with my paternal aunt, paternal uncle's wife, maternal uncle's wife, or my cousin's sisters, and forming an informal relationship with them, and having a laugh and joke with them? Yes, one's sister-in-law, paternal uncle's wife, paternal aunt, maternal uncle's wife, etc., are all considered ghair mahram in the eyes of Shariat. Therefore, Sharia has prohibited informalities with any of these women and any other woman who one is allowed to marry. And the same applies to women. They too must avoid contact with a non-mahrim man.